What's up, beautiful people, and welcome back to another sexy video where I say words and you peeps listen. It is I, your man of tomorrow, your steward of Gondor, your genius billionaire playboy, basic YouTuber philanthropist, Supercliff. And would you kindly hit that like and subscribe button, for every little bit helps in this YouTube world. DC Infinite Frontier is DC's upcoming relaunch initiative, which is set to begin this March in 2021, following DC's current experimental project, aka DC Future State. Now, in case you don't know what Future State is, then head down into this video's description where I have a link to my Future State Explained video. Moving on. Now, as I said prior, DC's Infinite Frontier is a relaunch, not a reboot like the New 52. Basically, treat this similar to the aftermath of 2018's New Justice by Scott Snyder, where we got a slew of new books which came after that story, such as Justice League Dark and Justice League Odyssey, along with new creative teams working on pre-existing ongoings and renumber ones, like Scott Snyder's Justice League and Bendis' Superman. Bendis is coming. I digress. I would say that the two major differences with Infinite Frontier when compared to past relaunches like Rebirth and New Justice is the first being that none of your typical series like Superman or Batman and so on are getting renumbered. Rather, all the ongoing books will continue with their respected books' previous numbered issue from last December. And the second, which is much more important, is that a lot of these issues will not only just feature the main story of said issue, but much like Future State, each issue will include an additional side story as well. And honestly, that's a dope approach. Because, you know, let's be honest, some DC characters can't hold a series on their own in regards to sales. So if you're, let's say, an avid Batman reader, you might get an issue where after the main Batman story, there's an additional story featuring the Huntress or possibly Clayface. And I think it allows DC to experiment with certain characters along with creative ideas, allowing a testing ground of sorts without canceling a book 6 issues in because it's not selling well. So yeah, that's pretty dope. Now, in regards to continuity, check it. DC's Infinite Frontier takes place following the events which transpired in Dark Knight's Death Metal, where Wonder Woman defeated the Batman Who Laughs and sacrificed herself using the powers of Anti-Crisis energy while the Batman Who Laughs was powered by Crisis energy. And thank God. Real talk, I don't hate Batman Who Laughs. All in all, he's definitely a cool concept, but Christ on a bike. This dude has been overused faster than a Kanye West rumor. I mean, just for the sake of humanity, have this guy sit out for the next 10 years or so. Anyways, in regards to Death Metal's ending, we sort of learned that beyond the DC multiverse, an infinite web of other multiverses are developing, which DC is labeling this as the Omniverse, and that hints of some bigger threat is looming beyond the interdimensional distance. And that's where we get into DC's Infinite Frontier Issue 0, which will serve as the Tree of Life, per se, for DC's new direction. Essentially, much like 2016's DC Universe Rebirth's one-shot, which was a must-read comic that set the stage for the future of the DC Universe, the Infinite Frontier comic will do the same. This one-shot is written by everyone, aka Scott Snyder, Geoff Johns, James Tynion IV, Josh Hill Williamson, Jeffrey Thorne, Philip Kennedy Johnson, Brian Michael Bendis, Becky Cloonan, Michael W. Conrad, Joel Jones, and Tim Sheridan, with the art by John Timms, Howard Porter, Julie Jones, George Jimenez, Alifia Martinez, David Marquez, Stephen Bryan, Jamal Egel, Dexter Soy, Rafa Sandoval, Alex Maeve, John Romita Jr., and many, many others. And this issue will come out on March 2nd, and it will cost $5.99. So yeah, there's that. And basically the summary of this one shot is the next phase of the DC Universe begins here. Dark Knight's Death Metal presented the darkest threats of the multiverse. DC Future State revealed what may lie ahead. Now it's time to look into the infinite frontier of the current day DC Universe. In Gotham City, the Joker jolts citizens awake with an attack even the Dark Knight never expected. In Brazil, a young woman discovers her destiny and her connection to the Amazons. In Bellerive, Amanda Waller plots an invasion of Arkham Asylum. And in the far reaches of space, Mongol dreams of galactic domination while the Green Lantern Corps hosts a summit of its greatest enemies. At the Hall of Justice, the League joins forces with Black Adam, because Dwayne Johnson. And beyond the mortal world, Wonder Woman settles into a new role in the Godsphere. And somewhere in the DC Universe, it's the return of Stargirl in an all-new tale written by Geoff Johns. This oversized all-star issue kicks off the next great era of storytelling and excitement as top writers and artists reveal what's next for the world's greatest heroes. It opens the door to some of the greatest stories of 2021. And now let's talk about all the upcoming books, where I will cover the Batman family Gotham-centric books first, followed by the Superman family books, followed by Justice League, Flash, and everyone else between the months March and April. And keep in mind that this list will not include books that have already begun. Therefore, I will not be mentioning Strange Adventures, Batman Catwoman, or the latest Super Sons digital series. Just an FYI. And now, let's get freaky. Starting off with Batman issue number 106, written by James Tynion IV, art by George Jimenez, with a backup story written by Joshua Williamson, with the art by Gilb Melenkov. Butchered your name, I apologize. And this issue will come out on March 2nd of 2021, and it'll be $4.99. Following the tragic events of Infinite Frontier, Batman and his new ally, Ghostmaker, must reckon with a new gang operating in Gotham City. But are they connected to the reemergence of the Scarecrow? Meanwhile, shadowy billionaire Simon Saint pitches an advanced law enforcement system to the new mayor. Plus the backup story, Demon or Detective, after everything Damian has gone through, can he escape Gotham and find his way back to where his journey started, to his mother, Talia al Ghul? Detective Comics 1034 is written by Mariako Tamaki and art by Dan Mora, with a backup story written by Joshua Williamson, with art by Gilb Melenkov. God, that name. And this issue will come out on March 23rd, and it'll be $4.99. The synopsis is DC Future State may be over, but the present looks tense. With the loss of his fortune and the manor, the election of Mayor Nakano, and a growing anti-vigilante sentiment in Gotham, Bruce Wayne must rethink on how to be Batman, or risk being left behind by his own city. Plus, in the second and concluding chapter of Demon or Detective, Damian Wayne meets a startling new faction from his family's checkered past. Woo! Catwoman issue number 29 is written by Ram V, with the art by Fernando Blanca, and it will come out March 16th of 2021. Nightwing issue number 78 is written by Tom Taylor, with the art by Bruno Redano, and it will be on sale March 16th of 2021, $3.99. Nightwing is back. Thank Christ. Batman and Superman issue number 16 is written by all-star Jean Loon Yang, with the art by Ivan Rice and Danny Mickey, and this issue will be on sale March 23rd of 2021, price tag $3.99. In the aftermath of the Dark Knight's death metal, catch a glimpse of brave new worlds within the DC Universe as we delve into the parallel lives of the Man of Steel and the Dark Knight. Batman Urban Legends issue number 1 is written by Marvel All-Star Chip Zdarsky, Matthew Rosenberg, Stephanie Phillips, and Brandon Thomas, with the art by Eddie Barrows, Marcos Toe, Ryan Benjamin, Laura Braga, and Max Dunbar. And this issue will come out March 9th of 2021, $7.99 is the price, and it's more like an anthology series, so you get multiple stories in one package. Joker issue number 1 is written by James Tynion IV, with a backup story written by James Tynion IV and Sam Johns, with the art by Gemmell March, and the backup story art by Mirka Andolfa. And that will be on sale March 9th, and it'll be $4.99. And the synopsis is, the Joker is the most wanted man in the world, but the clown prince of crime is several steps ahead of law enforcement, and he's on the run overseas. James Gordon, facing retirement, realizes this is the manhunt of his life. But what mysterious and already deadly force are also in pursuit of the Joker? And in the backup story, following the events of the smash hit Punchline No. 1, DC's most controversial new villain navigates the infrastructure of Blackgate Penitentiary, while on the outside, Harper Row takes up the mantle of Bluebird to stop her brother from falling under Punchline's influence. Next, we got Harley Quinn issue number 1, written by Stephanie Phillips, with the art by Riley Rosmo. This will be released on March 23rd, with a price tag at $3.99. Robin issue number 1 will be written by Josh Elliot Williamson, with the art by Gilb Melenkov. I gotta get better at that. And this series will be on sale on April 27th. It'll be $3.99. Batman and the Dark Knight issue number 1 will be written by Tom Taylor, with the art by Andy Kubert. This series will begin on April 13th. The next Batman, Second Son, issue number 1, is written by John Ridley, with the art by Tony Atkins, Travel Foreman, and Mark Morales. On sale April 6th. With a $4.99 price tag. Readers now know that after the events of Future State, Tim Fox is the next Batman. But what's his origin story? These questions and many more will be explored in this thrilling new digital first miniseries. And now, let's get freaky with the Superman-centric family titles. Starting with Superman. Issue 29 is written by Philip Kennedy Johnson, with the art by Phil Hester. And the synopsis being is that this is the Golden Age, part 1. Jonathan Kent is back from the 31st century and fighting cosmic threats alongside his legendary father. And this issue will come out on sale on March 2nd. Action Comics issue 1029 will also be written by Philip Kennedy Johnson, with the art by Eric Gopster. And this is the Golden Age Part 2. Oh, and FYI, Action Comics and Superman will heavily play alongside one another. If you're going to end up reading one or the other, you may end up having to read both. Superman Red and Blue, issue number one, is the first issue out of six, and it's being written by Margaret Bennett. And, you know, essentially, if you are familiar with Batman Black and White, this is the same deal, but for Superman Red and Blue, because, you know, red and blue. And this issue comes out on March 9th of 2021 with a price tag at $5.99. And here we go, folks. Now let's move on to the other avenues of the DC Universe, starting with Crime Syndicate, issue number one. Is written by Annie Schmidt with the art by Karen McCown. And this is a six-issue miniseries. And the synopsis being is that spinning out of the Dark Knight's death metal, the DC multiverse is reborn, and with it, a new Earth 3. What if the Justice League decided to rule the world instead of protecting it? That's the team we have right here, right now. Starring Ultraman, a narcissist, somewhat like Homelander, Superwoman, a nihilist, Owlman, a broken moral compass, Power Ring, a sociopath, Johnny Quick, and Atomica. Does the world stand a chance? Who knows? And this comic will be on sale March 2nd, 2021. Justice League, issue number 59, written by Brian Michael Bendis, with the art by David Marquez, with a backup story written by Ram V, and it will be on sale March 16th of 2021, with a price tag at $4.99. Check it. Brian Michael Bendis reunites with the artist David Marquez for a new star-stud Justice League featuring Superman, Batman, The Flash, Hawkgirl, Aquaman, Hippolyta, and new DC powerhouse Naomi. Oh, and is that Black Adam in the background? Hell yeah. And the backup story written by Ram V will feature Justice League Dark. So if you like magic and dark stuff, there you go. Flash issue number 768 is written by Jeremy Adams, drawn by Brandon Peterson. In this story, from what I've been hearing, is that this Flash arc will fix Wally West. So if you guys love Wally West, you're in luck, because he's gonna get his reputation back, finally. And this book comes out March 16th of 2021. The Swamp Thing, issue number one, written by Ram V with the art by Mike Perkins. And this is a 10-issue miniseries that stars Levi Cammy as the next Guardian of the Green. Unable to control his transformation into the monstrous Swamp Thing, Levi is thrust into the harsh, unforgiving mystery of grisly murders committed by a supernatural desert legend. Levi must revisit past events in his homeland of India and face the deadly reality of a ravenous new villain in order to comprehend what he is horrifyingly becoming. A new era of global action and horror blossoms here, and Swamp Thing will be at the root of it. Pun. The Suicide Squad, issue number one, written by Robbie Thompson with the art by Eduardo Pensica. This series starts off with a bang as Waller sends Peacemaker and Task Force X to recruit its next member, Talon, the master assassin from the Court of Owls. Meanwhile, she has her hands full as she tries to recruit Superboy. This issue will come out on March 2nd of 2021. Teen Titans Academy, issue number one, is written by the infamous Tim Sheridan with the art by Rafa Sandoval. And this features the original Titans, Nightwing, Starfire, Cyborg, Raven, and Beast Boy, teaching a school of a new generation of teenage crime fighters, with one of these novice heroes being the character of Red X. Ooh. This issue comes out on March 16th, 2021. Basically, if you like the old school X-Men stories back in like the 60s, bad example, but you get the idea, then you'll probably enjoy this. Wonder Woman 770. Written by Becky Cloonan with the art by Travis Moore. And in this new arc, Diana has to endure endless fighting and partying as she tries to figure out why she's in Valhalla and why nobody seems surprised that she's there. This issue will come on sale on March 9th, 2021. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, we have Green Lantern, written by Jeffrey Thorne with the art by Dexter Soy. And this issue will come out April 6th of 2021. Check it. Cops are back, and a new Green Lantern, Jon Stewart, is at the center of a new series, along with Young Justice's Teen Lantern and the Far Sector Green Lantern. As this new Green Lantern saga begins, the newly formed United Planets and the Guardians of the Universe hold an intergalactic summit to decide who can best serve and protect Cosmos from danger. And there you have it, peeps. Everything you need to know for DC's Infinite Frontier. Now tell me, what are you guys most excited for? What books will you be picking up? And if you somehow are not excited, then please share that as well. This channel welcomes any for friendly discussion. Leave your thoughts, comments, and opinions in the comment section below. And if you like what you see, slash here, then hit that like and subscribe button. Follow me on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. And until next time, peace. Giggity giggity goo.